This week's topic is avoiding a medical disaster. Now, it may not come as a surprise to you, but medical bills are the leading cause for people filing bankruptcy. According to a 2013 study by NerdWallet, over 20% of American adults are struggling to pay their medical bills, and 3 out of 5 bankruptcies will be due to medical bills. Now, one reason for this is illness. Oftentimes leads to job loss, which in turn affects people on two fronts. You may lose employer health provided health insurance coverage, and with no paycheck, medical bills go unpaid. Now, some deplete their savings, some people take money out of 401ks, some people will run up credit card bills in order to pay their expenses. Now, don't assume that you're not vulnerable even if you have medical insurance. Another interesting study by NerdWallet indicated that 10 million Americans aged 19 to 64 had continuous coverage for a full year prior to having financial troubles and facing bankruptcy. Because of high copays and deductibles and unreimbursed expenses that they incurred. So how do you go about avoiding these issues? Well, one way to do it is be clear as to what your plan does or does not cover. Another thing is don't automatically choose the cheapest plan, because that can come with higher deductibles and higher copays that can potentially get someone in trouble. Research the cost ahead of time for certain procedures and things that you may need. Hospitals have varying costs for those sorts of things, and sometimes the amount you pay could potentially go up, or you may not be covered. Review your medical bills carefully as well. NerdWallet indicated that almost half of the medical bills that people received were incorrect, and you needed to correct them. And if your claim is rejected by your insurer, be persistent. If you feel the bill should be paid, stay on top of it. Maintaining coverage is important. Even if you do lose your job, you can most times end up getting COBRA insurance. And you can also check out the website healthcare.gov for any government insurance that might be available to you. A couple of outside things. Building an emergency reserve can help in that situation, especially if you build it prior to having a problem. You can also use flexible spending accounts or health savings accounts to get monies put away to pay for some of these expenses. And if both husband and wife are working, you may want to coordinate your coverage and see which plans make the most sense for you. And finally, keep a good, healthy lifestyle going. Improving your health is one way to staying healthy, and another way of doing that, of course, is staying healthy, exercising, and minimizing risky behavior that can affect your health.